always do what you can, do what feels right for your body. So since this is ENMU Reads, I wanted to share a few books really quick. For those of you who say I would rather read than do yoga, I understand. So there's a very cool, there's tons of yoga books out there, but this particular one, Yoga for Life with Colleen Sedman Yee, is very, very, it's her life journey, it's her journey with yoga. So it's her story. I love reading personal stories, so you may like this. It's also inspirational because she's in her 60s now. And the other thing is that a lot of people don't know that yoga involves ethical practices. So yoga is not just a movement of our body and the breathing and the meditation. It's also the yamas and niyamas. So if you're someone who likes to read and likes to journal and explore, you know, intrinsic thought, internal speculation, kind of thinking about yourself and how you're living, this is very cool. It's simple enough and deep enough. It's a nice combination. So the yamas and niyamas, Exploring Yoga's Ethical Practice by Deborah Adele, is something else I would recommend. Some other minor points here is that if you are just trying yoga for the first time today, I just want you to know that it's always good to have modifications, to use modifications, meaning doing a pose to your level, to your practice, the way it feels good for you. And even if you're advanced, many people use yoga blocks or pillows. I didn't bring a pillow with me right now, a pillow or a blanket. Or when you're on your knees, you know, or something like this, you can always roll up the mat if it's feeling like it's too much on your knees. So just keep that in mind. We'll leave this here. And we will get started today standing. So I'm going to put on a little music on low, and I may, bring it up or down sometimes. So just to share that. And we will begin in one sec here. Excuse me. Thanks for your patience there. So, as we are standing, you know, this has been kind of a week with a fair amount of stress. There's still a fair amount of stress. So let's get started by making sure we're energized and then releasing some stress through breathing. So if your body feels a little stiff, if you've been sitting, something you can do, and it's also great for stress, is tapping. So you just cup your hands and move anywhere on the body that feels good for you. You know, but try to hit most points, legs, going behind, going in the front, going on your sides. Low back can feel awesome, particularly again if you sit a lot. Bringing it up to the shoulders, down one arm, down another arm.
We had someone ask, can you share the books again real quick?
Oh, sure. Absolutely. So
before we dive in full
blast. Yeah, absolutely. So Yoga for Life, Colleen Sedman Yee. So her journey into yoga as an instructor, and now her and her husband are very well known. They're in their 60s and they're teaching. So I think it's really an inspiration. And the yamas and niyamas are ethical practices, principles related to yoga, and each one is probably 5 pages of reading and introspective questions to yourself. Okay, all right. So we are doing our tapping, making sure that we are energized and ready to roll today, getting a little circulation in the body. You know, whatever feels good. Tapping is supposed to be really good for releasing anxiety and stress. Sometimes there's a specific technique where you do it exactly a certain way. I'm not doing that right now. Might feel really good around your neck, around your shoulders. So another thing is in yoga, we're always trying to synchronize our breath with our movement. We do a lot of breathing either to release tension and anxiety or to get energized. So for today, we're going to do some releasing. So this is kind of a cleansing breath, which I would say is we're taking it to the second power, because there isn't really an exact name for this breathing that we're going to do now. So what you want to do is inhale up. As you rise up, big inhale, feeling it in your belly. Big inhale. And then a big release through the mouth as we come down, bend the knees. Exhale. Inhale up. Big inhale, keep inhaling. Exhale down. Again, inhale up. And exhale down. So I'm going to do six of these fast. So I'd like you to do them with me, releasing that energy and that stress from the week. Just let it go. Put it aside. Breathe it out. Inhale. Exhale. Last one. Let it out. Nice. Whew. So let's shake it out a little bit. And just take the arms and just shaking side to side. You can bend the knees. Again, we're kind of releasing the energy of the week, any stress, anything kind of hanging on your body before we begin our practice. Do anything you'd like here. You can be a little goofy. It's Friday. Have fun with it. Go a little low, a little high, and we'll slow it down. So just naturally taking it slower, becoming aware of the breath as we synchronize breath with movement. Okay, nice. So synchronizing our breath with our movement. We're going to go ahead and extend out. Inhale, bring it together. Exhale. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, prayer, hands come down. We bow down. Take it to the other side. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale again. Exhale, bowing down. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale up. Exhale, bow down. One more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale up. Exhale, bowing down. Beautiful. So let's go ahead and take it down now. And if you have a block or a pillow, we're just going to take a moment in the sitting posture for a moment of meditation, just briefly. So you can sit on it and it brings your knees down, which is really good for your back. So coming into a comfortable seated posture, you want to feel grounded down in your sits bones, nice long spine, rolling the shoulders back, closing the eyes just for a minute. You can have your hands up or down, whatever feels best for you. On this Friday morning, opening the chest, neck is in a natural position, and we just notice the breath. Just closing the eyes, focusing on the breath. So from here, let's set an intention for your practice, for your day. So we're going to inhale up, bring the hands together, come in prayer hands, and think of your I am as you release, exhale, and come down. So I am strong, I am focused, I am grounded, I am grateful, whatever works for you. Take a moment with that affirmation, that thought. we'll take it two times. Inhale up, exhale down with the I am thought coming to the heart center. Inhale up, prayer hands come together, exhale down with your I am thought. Breathing, focusing on that just for a moment, for your practice, for your day, for your week, whatever works for you. Big inhale and exhale through the mouth as we release again. Slowly opening the eyes, taking some movement, removing the block or the pillow if you do have it on your sits bones. And we are going to come into the mat and begin with child's pose here. So you do want to be sitting on your heels. Your back is straight, spine is straight, roll the shoulders back, inhale up, stretching up, active child's pose here. Extending out. All five finger pads are gripping the mat as you release, exhale, and extend out. Now, usually people are coming up like that. What you want to do is bring it down as far as you can towards your heels. You can put a pillow here and just activate so that you feel an active stretch all the way from the low back throughout your body, neck, and these activated fingers, hands, arms, and breathe. Inhale up, exhale, release the shoulders down, come down as far as you can. One more time, inhale up, exhale, we're going to release it down as far as you can. Inhale up, let's take it over to the right side. So your left hand is going to be next to your right hand, or if you're very flexible, you can put it on top. And release down, feeling that stretch in the left side body here. Breathe, always go to the breath. Inhale up, taking it over to the left side. And right hand is going to be beside the left hand or on top of it. Bringing the head down towards the earth, feeling that beautiful stretch in the right side body. Deep breath in and out. Beautiful. Taking it back over to the center. Now we're bringing our legs together. Still heels, bottom and heels are together. Bringing the forehead to the mat and palms are up. As we come down to do some movement synchronized with our breath. Engaging the quads here in Bali Seal. So inhale, rising up on the knees, and of course you can put a pillow there. Inhale, exhale, mini back bend if that's okay for you. If it's too much, don't do it. Inhale up, exhale down. Inhale, exhale, inhale, rising up, exhale back. Inhale up, exhale. Inhale down, two more. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Beautiful. Coming back here, let's take tabletop. So, excuse me, in tabletop, you want to, as always, grip the mat with all five finger pads. You're feeling the tops of your feet here. Always tuning into your body, how it feels. And we have the wrists in line with the shoulders, knees in line with the hips. Feeling a little bit of tightening here in the belly as we keep a nice, strong back. And we're going to take our cat-calf. So inhale, looking up. Pelvic area goes up, the belly goes down into our cow, releasing there and looking up as we inhale. Exhale, opposite. Navel into the spine, curling up into cat as far as you can. Inhale, up, exhale.
take the spine as far as you can go in both movements. This is like a massage for your spine. Very, very good for the body, often used in PT. So take it at your own pace, looking up, inhaling, exhaling down, inhale up, exhale down. Take two more at your own pace, taking it as far as you can with the movement of your spine going up, going down, and synchronizing with the breath. Last one. And come back to a neutral spine here. Let's take some hip circles going around to the right. Take it three times to the right. And take it over to the left. Very nice. Just loosening up there a little bit. So we're going to take our first down dog. Down dog can be very difficult if you're not used to it and you put your weight on your wrist. So we're going to demonstrate how to keep that weight away from your wrist. So curl the toes, lifting up through the knees, up all the way through the pelvic area, shooting up to the sky, and then you start to pull your weight away from your wrist, bringing it back, lengthening the back, bringing the weight towards the heels, and then you can bend your knees. So that's okay. Even this is better than going like this. So try it out for yourself. Go ahead and let the weight come to your wrists, and then lift yourself to bring it away from the wrist, because we do not want to hurt the wrist. Take some movement here, just bending the knees back and forth. Okay. Static in dead dog, in down dog is a little bit hard, so you want to get some movement going here, feeling comfortable. Now, one other trick you can take is open your legs wider than the mat, and then bring your weight back and up. And so then you can really feel that sensation that my wrists are safe. Okay, so that's also very good. So we'll bring it back to where we were and come back down, and we're going to take a cat-cow down dog combination. So three animals we've got going on here, okay, for this Friday. So inhale up, exhale, curling the back. Inhale, curl the toes, exhale, back and down dog. Take a breath, bring it back down. Inhale, curl the toes, exhale, coming back. One breath, and then coming down on the knees to inhale, exhale. Inhale, curl the toes, coming back. And last time, down on the knees. Inhale up, exhale down. Curling the toes on the inhale, exhaling as the heels come down. One breath, and then coming back. Beautiful. If you feel that you want a little bit of movement again in the hips, we can take it side to side. Stretching things out. And we're going to go back to your down dog. So again, curl the toes, lift up, look to the hands, and just take these little happy steps, coming towards your hands and coming to the front of your mat. Then we're going to grab opposite elbows. You can bend your knees and take forward fold, exhaling down. So you're going to feel a great release, stretch in the low back, on the inside of the thighs here, or the back, I should say. You might feel it in other parts of your back. So good for you to do this. Just take another exhale, release down lower. Just bring it as far as you can. And then inhale, coming up. Very mindfully, very slowly. Let's bring the hands up too. Coming all the way up, coming to prayer hands, exhaling down, and just taking a moment here.
very slow to give a lot of guidance, and then I'm going to go a little bit faster. Okay? So inhaling up, reaching out to the sky, exhaling down, touching the toes, bend the knees as you need to. Inhale, halfway lift. So halfway lift is not this. You can try this first, rounding the back. It's this, stretching out, but looking down still to keep the spine in one line with the neck. This again is such a good stretch for here and here. So take that for a moment, get the feel of that, then exhale down, inhale, coming all the way up, exhale down, inhale, halfway lift, long back, okay? And exhale down, frame the feet. So we're gonna bring the right foot back, knee is down to the mat, and I do have the mound of my right foot there. Rounded down on the left foot and the back and on the right foot, tightening in the hips here as we slowly rise up. You can stay here if you'd like, if that feels best for you. If you're feeling okay and stable and strong, then you're going to come all the way up, bring your hands up, open your chest, extend your arms, hands, and energize within this pose, Anjani Asana. Exhale down. Frame left foot, bringing it back to the right, and we're in down dog. Again, feeling your weight coming towards your heels. Then you're going to inhale, coming forward into a high plank. So, high plank is a tough one. You're pushing against the earth, and it's okay to have your bum up a little bit because that's safer for your back than bringing it way down. So you can have it up just a little bit here. And then we're going to come down, knees, chest, chin. Inhale, baby cobra. Baby cobra, you can see that my hands, I can move. I'm just using my upper body. Exhale, down. Inhale, lift up. Coming back to down dog. And we were on the right side, so we go to the right leg, lifting it up in three-legged dog. Bringing it between the hands. Left knee is down. And we rise up again, or stay here. Exhale down, bringing that left foot to the right. Beautiful. I'm going to pause for 1 second here. Okay, and we're rising up. Taking it on the left, exhale down. Inhale, halfway lift, left foot comes back, feeling grounded in this right foot now in the mound of my left. I can stay here or I can come all the way up in Ujjayi Asana. Take a breath. And exhale, frame the foot. And we come back to down dog. Beautiful. On an inhale, high plank, pushing against the earth. And come down, knees, chest, chin, in a controlled, safe manner. Inhale, baby cobra. Exhale, down. Inhale, shooting up again to down dog. Checking your down dog, making sure that you have a long back. Inhale, left foot comes up, three-legged dog. Bring it between the feet. Knee comes down on the right. Inhale, rising up. And exhale, down. Bring that foot to reach the other one, and we are back. Beautiful. So I hope you guys are doing well, you're trying that out. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna do it faster and just focus on the breathing in case you wanna try it faster. Take a quick sip of water. You may need a sip of water as well. Okay, here we go. Inhale, exhale, inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, right foot back. Rising up on an inhale, exhale, frame, inhale, exhale, back, inhale, forward, exhale, come down. Inhale, halfway lift, exhale, down, inhale, back up. Exhale, inhale, bring the right foot up,
are on the left side. Left leg goes up. Inhale, exhale between left hand, sorry. Knee comes down and you rise up. And you bring the hands down and both feet together as we ended that sequence on both sides. Beautiful. So, let's take mountain pose for a minute. So in mountain pose, you feel like you're doing nothing, but you're doing something. So you are actually wanting to engage your feet, feeling like you're gripping mud. So pressing down on the front of your feet and the back. Okay, and then lifting the kneecaps to engage the quads. Low back is down, or pelvic area is down. Tightening the belly, opening the chest, rolling the shoulders back, and then we engage through the arms to the fingertips, looking forward. So mountain pose is generally the pose we take before and after we do a sequence. So you can take your mountain, come back to the breath. Deep breaths. Okay, so from here, let's go ahead and take a nice wide step. So take a step that feels as wide as you can take, but you still have a nice safe grip. And we're gonna demonstrate warrior two and just do some movement with warrior two. So let's take warrior two. So basically we started with our feet forward, and then on the right, I'm bending my knee. And I have to take it a little wider on the mat here, and we're trying to get heel to heel, and the knee should be about over the ankle. It should not be extending way far like this. Hands come open, and we look at the middle finger of our right hand. Now we're going to take this with movement. So since we're doing it with movement, your knee will come over a little bit on the over the ankle a little bit. So we're going to inhale. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. So this gives you a sense of what warrior two feels like. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, turning the head with it. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Take it one more side, inhale. Inhale, exhale, beautiful. So from here, with this wide stance, you're going to come down, and if you have a block, you can use a block, you can use something so that you can come down and touch the earth. So we're going to exhale, come down. Both hands are either on a block or touching the earth, looking down, taking that beautiful stretch from the low back. Inhale, right hand comes up as we stretch all the way up to the sky, and exhale down, taking it on the left. Inhale up, exhale down, back to the right. Inhale up, exhale down, and again, inhale up, exhale down. Little things mean a lot with yoga, so there's a big difference between going like this and going all the way up to open that shoulder. So keep that in mind too. So as you're coming up, you may feel that you need to bend your knees for safety. That's okay. Do what works best for your body. Always tune into your body. So from here, again with a wide stance, my feet will not go straight. I'm going to bring them at a 45 degree angle and bend the knees now. So this is like a second position in ballet, I think. So you're bending down, you're gonna feel a lot of engagement in these quads, low back, your bottom. This is really good for you. So we're gonna take some goddess. So we're gonna go down, we're exhaling, going down as far as you can go. Please notice your bum, that you're not doing this, but you're trying to bring it down straight, opening the shoulders as far as you can, coming down. Inhale, come up. So, star pose up, exhale down. Inhale,
if that doesn't work for you, take a rest. This is your body, your practice. Looks like we're not doing much, but I bet you guys are feeling it. Okay. And coming up on an inhale, releasing, bringing those feet together very nicely. Let's rise up, stretch. Exhale, down, forward, fold. Inhale, halfway lift, just to give this to the back. One more time, exhale down, and we will rise up again. Beautiful. So let's do just a little bit of balance. Excuse me. Before you take a balanced posture, you want to make sure that you have your breath slow and steady, and that you found a place to focus on that is not moving. So we call it a drishti. So you want to dial into something so that you feel that you can bring your heart rate down and do a little bit of balancing. So go ahead and take a breath, find a focus point. Let's take the feet back and forth to get that sensation of balancing in one leg compared to the other. Okay. And then when you're ready, you're going to put all the weight on your left side and bring up your right, bend the knee, and focus. Ooh, my balance is not strong today on Friday. So if you're feeling like that, we are together. Holding the leg up and exhale down. So something else about yoga is that every day our body's a little different, and sometimes you may feel more flexible, more strong, more balanced. It changes. It's not 100% consistent. That's also why we call yoga a practice. So then all the way on the right, and we're going to go ahead and lift up the left. And slowly bringing it down. And then we're going to come down to the feet, balancing a little bit more. But if you do have a foot injury or an ankle injury, you don't need to do this. It could be too much. So we're just focusing on the tops, the mounds of our feet here. And your hands are, fingers are touching down with the earth. As you find your focus, you can bring your hands up. And slowly coming down. And this is not a graceful way to come down. Come down any way you can here on your bottom. We're going to bring the feet together, extend the knees out, and take butterfly. Just moving back and forth here. Feels so good for the inner thighs. Beautiful. Coming down on the back now with my knees bent, flat to the mat. Shoulders, all parts of the back are flat to the mat. Let's extend the arms out as we inhale, and as we exhale, we're going to lift up the hips in a bridge pose. Excuse me. So actually bring your feet a little closer to your bottom so that it's a little tighter there between the feet and the bottom. And then we'll inhale, exhale, as the hands come down, the bottom comes up for a mini bridge. And take it again, inhaling and exhaling, however it works that you synchronize your breath with your movement. And we'll take three more, pushing down into the earth with your feet to rise your bottom up as high as it works for you. And on this last one, we're going to take it just a little bit further. So if you can, intertwine your fingers to make a fist with both hands underneath your bottom here. And tighten up and lift up a little bit higher.
see if you can hold that. And a little bit higher. Always breathe. And exhale, slowly bringing it down. We're going to bend the knees and grab opposite elbows and just move back and forth, massaging the low back, bringing our practice down here. Very nice. And let's take the knees bent to one side so you can go with your right. And my right hand is touching over on the legs and the knees as I extend my left arm out and look to the left. So this is a nice little side stretch as we're coming down. Take some deep breaths. Inhale, coming back up, bending the knees, taking it to the left, and my left hand is touching down here, and my right hand is extending out as I am looking, opening the chest, and taking a little stretch here. Beautiful. Coming back to bending the knees here and massaging the low back. And we're going to take it down to bring you down to a very quick shavasana as we end the practice. So just stay where you are, massage your back, do what you need to do. So from here, inhale, tighten up. Just tighten everything up as tight as you can be, and then exhale, release out. Allow the legs, arms, hands to open up and extend to the side. And just take a moment for yourself in a shavasana. So you're releasing all the muscles into the mat. Visualizing yourself melting into the mat. Starting from the feet, calves, thighs, bottom, low back, mid back, high back, shoulders melting into the mat, through the arms, through the fingertips. Go back to your affirmation, your I am. For a moment, and with a deep inhale and exhale, let's release that. Inhale, exhale, beautiful. Now taking some movement in your feet and your fingertips, just taking a quick shavasana, so we'll go ahead and mindfully come back up, coming up slowly to a seated posture. Come back to a comfortable posture the way we began our practice today. You do want your spine to be nice and strong and long all the way through the tops of your head, top of your head. Taking a deep breath. Song here, if you're hearing it, it's called The Opening, allowing your heart to be open. So with that thought, let's inhale, bring the hands up to prayer hands. Allow your prayer hands to touch your forehead as a reminder of conscious living, compassionate thoughts, bringing your thumbs to your mouth as a reminder to speak our truth with compassion. And finally, to the heart center for a joyful, grateful heart. Inhale, exhale. Thank you for
joining me today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please leave any comments or questions.